this in a bundle for really quite cheap ages ago. Never really got around to playing it though. I actually had the original Assassin's Creed, played quite a lot of it, but never actually managed to complete it, and got a bit frustrated at some parts of it. Eventually gave up. But yeah, I thought I'd just have a little wander around, if for nothing but just locations and history and stuff. I found this interesting building. I thought I'd just have a little bit of a look around it, and then I believe there's some information you can read. So I'll just read through that. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Looks like a cathedral. A very old style tall building there. I believe that's what that is. I managed to quite jump over that. You can see why I got frustrated with Assassin's Creed. I'm not very good at it, to put it lightly. Nope, there we go, managed that one. Yeah, I believe a lot of the really old tall buildings like that, they used to build completely square. Although, maybe I'm just mixing my history up there. But yeah, it's got really cool patterning all over it. Not sure what materials they made those particular colours out of. I'm wondering if I can get across somehow. I don't really want to risk jumping across there. I might have a go climbing up at some point. I'll just walk around it for now. Have a look at it from the other side. Yeah, I've only played a really, really tiny amount of this game so far. You can probably tell that from the clothes I'm wearing. I think after the intro, I guess you get your Assassin's Creed looking clothes. At the moment, I'm just in the stuff you're wearing in the intro. Not quite sure how to get across here. We go down to here and then walk across here. Maybe. Yeah. There we go. All sneaky beaky like. Oh, almost. almost. There we go. I can see it from a different angle. Looks a bit down from this angle. Some of the patterns fell off. That big round window with the bars on it doesn't look totally natural. Maybe that's some part of the story that I've not got to yet though. Have a look on the other side and then I'll have a little read about it. Maybe the information in the game will tell me about that. Here. Oh no, I'm going out of the zone. Area not yet available. I best not go out of there. I'll get wandering back across. But yeah, as I said, I haven't yet really got out of the tutorial. This may not be the best time to go exploring. But yeah, anyway. So, about it. Have a good start. I believe it was in database. Locations. Not that one. I think that's the tower. That's the whole thing. We'll read the whole thing first. And then I'll have a look at specifically the tower. So, Santa Maria del Fiore. One of Italy's largest churches. The largest landmark in Florence, Santa Maria del Fiore, is considered by many to be the first masterpiece of Renaissance architecture. Although the church was designed by Arnolfo di Cambio in 1296, same artist that he had lost to before. That guy invented machines to hoist the bricks needed for the dome, hooked the workers, and was able to construct the entire dome without using centering, a support structure to hold the dome in place while bricks were laid. Containing over 4 million bricks, the dome was completed in 1436. Was added after that guy's death in 1446 and supposedly contains holy relics. However, there were several rumors that, in fact, an entire tomb of unknown origin is located inside. I guess that's gonna come into the story at some point. Okay, that's the end of that. I'll read about the tower a little bit. Giotto's Campanelli, begun by Giotto di Bondone, the famous architect and painter. In 1334, this famous Gothic bell tower was incomplete when Giotto died. Andrea Pisano took over, and then in 1348 was felled by the Black Death. Was completed by Francesco Talenti, who deviated from Giotto's plan in his design of the upper three floors. He enlarged each floor to match the previous according to perspective, so when seen from below, all three floors seem to be exactly the same size. The tower is clad with white marble from Carrara, red marble from Siena, and green marble from Prato. It takes exactly 414 steps to reach the top, perhaps predicting Charles Messier's discovery of the Whirlpool galaxy exactly 414 years later, or perhaps not. That would be a big coincidence. Okay. So those are those two. There's also something nearby which looks interesting as well. I believe we wandered up to almost, where is it? Not that one. Oh, there it is, over there. That looks interesting. Have a little look over there. If we can get over there. My assassin skills are pretty terrible. I made it. There we go. Yeah, but this game, it surprised me with its odd humour. I didn't realise some Assassin's Creed games were a bit weirdly funny in a way. Action. You were a baby and you were pressing the buttons and it was making you move around according to which ones you pressed. It was very weird. I've never played this game before and I certainly wasn't expecting that. I remember the first Assassin's Creed being a bit more serious. Okay. But yeah, it wasn't like it took me out of the game anyway. I just didn't realise for a minute if they were being serious or messing around. And then it just kinda made me laugh when I realised it was just messing around. But yeah, this is a very cool building. Kind of like a sort of medieval castle should be able to climb into this. There we go. Climb up it a little bit. Might even be able to get all the way up there. Are we going to get ourselves in trouble? That's the question. Looks like a prison almost. Can we get up? It's got the same design where it goes out again. No, we can't climb from that side. Maybe we need to climb a door. There we go. Get around here. Go up there. Can we get up there? There you go. Same time, it's just maybe I'm just a bit too scared of heights. There we go. We're really high up here. This might be the highest bit in the game, to be honest. There, that's where we were. I think, no. Oh no, that's a different place. That's where we were. Actually, that looks like the highest place in the game. But this is pretty close. Can we get right to the top? Ooh, might be able to. No. Oh no. Can't get right to the top. Never mind. We can do the eagle vision thing up here though. I never really know what this thing does. Synchronize. Spin around. Oh, I guess it gives you new places on the map. It says map updated. There's an eagle up here. And there we go. I think I'll read a little bit about this place. I'll just get down first so you can see a bit more of it. Goodness, how do we get down? Assassin man. There we go. Come on. Come on. Oh yeah, I actually also got Assassin's Creed Black Flag. I got that for free from Ubisoft. Can I just... Assassin's Creed Black Flag for free on Uplay, I believe their store is. That's actually what got me into playing through this. Thought maybe I've been missing out on some things, so I thought I'd just catch up a little bit and see what was going on in the Assassin's Creed world. Seem like a good game so far, but we'll see. I can drop over there. Okay. So, oh no, that was almost a very bad move. Maybe down there. There you go. That works out better. There we go. So. Says locations, not that one, it's that one, yeah, that's it, Palazzo della Towers of Florence, the Signoria. I'm probably pronouncing that completely wrong, but we'll go with it. The Signoria was made up of 9 members of priori, selected by the city's guilds, 2 from each district, and a Gonfalonia of Justice. Members were supposed to be chosen by lot, but once the Medici family took power, only their friends seemed to end up in the drawing. Government by the people, right? Interesting fact. The tower in front is off-center because it was incorporated into the Palazzo from an earlier structure. It contains 2 small cells, one of which was used to imprison Cosimo de' Medici. There you go. I guess that's in the story at some point. It's interesting. You can actually see this slightly off-center. You can also see that the windows directly below where the tower is are slightly different as well. There we go. Anyway, I think I will leave it at that for now. I hope you enjoyed watching. It's a little bit of reading and history.